Warm welcome to all our viewers. Let me start by saying that Neuro Leadership Institute is very grateful to all our participants who reposed their trust in our coaching program and helped us to remain at the top with back-to-back batches running nonstop right through successive lockdowns. With 3,000 plus certified coaches in India alone and a thriving online community, brain-based coaching has certainly made its mark in the world of coaching. So a big shout out to our alumni out there. Today, we are joined by Naimish Majmudar, AVP People Development and OD with UFO Movies, a media company operating globally. Welcome, Naimish, to this very brief conversation.
Hi, good morning, Soumen. Wonderful to be here. Thank you.
Good morning. Good morning. And yeah, we are glad to have this conversation. I'm going to ask you some very simple questions and expect your very candid answers.
Sure.
By saying that, you know, asking this question, that most of our participants, you know, before they get into any program on coaching, because coaching has now become a very popular subject, they do their research. You know, there are many coaching schools which offer different you know, ways of, you know, developing coaching skills, and I'm sure you must have done yours too. And then you chose brain-based coaching. At the end of this program, having gone through this pretty intense program for like, I think, 6.5-7 months almost, or maybe more, I don't know. Okay, was your expectations met?
Yeah, the idea is to be candid here, so I'm going to be as candid as possible. And then not to sound flattering, but my expectations really were exceeded this time with this course. So I'll go to the extent of saying that this has probably been one of my most enriching learning experiences throughout my career. Coaching is something that came to me over a period of time. You know, my profession is such where I have to constantly look at ways of incorporating different methods to enhance not only the skill sets of people who I work with, but also myself. So it's always about upskilling. And towards that, I kept hearing about coaching and, you know, the methodologies and how it's important and how it can help. So I kept doing my research, and finally, something really clicked with Neuro Leadership, which is that I have always been very, very attracted to the way the brain functions. You know, how does a brain function and how does it help you become better? Look at things in a more deeper way. And then I came across Neuro Leadership. You know, I attended a couple of sessions where I got a little in-depth understanding of how the entire program flows and what are the things that you focus on, in which the research based on neuroscience took prominence in most of the aspects. And that kind of got me really interested, because it is research based, it is scientific, which means that it is factual. And when you bring in facts and research into learning, it becomes a potent combination. And that is what I was looking for. One, for myself, to upskill myself. I was very intrigued as to how this entire thing functions. And two, for the value that I can drive forward. So the entire program, the way it is structured, the way it is facilitated, it just really exceeded my expectations. I'm very, very happy to have taken this decision.
Thank you, Naimish. I think that's wonderful to hear. And of course, neuroscience, once you're touched by it, it won't let you go.
Yeah.
It is an extremely deep and intense science, and I think the beauty is that you know why we do what we do, and therefore I think that adds to that flavor. So great comments there. How was the virtual experience? This was all virtual, remember? I mean, there was not one physical contact, and over a period of like 7 months, how was the experience?
Yeah. Good question. Actually, I have to admit that I was a little skeptical in the beginning about, you know, how this whole thing will turn out, because being a facilitator myself, we've been so used to having those physical touch points, you know, in a learning environment, and it has its own importance. It can never be taken away. But this the way it was organized, you know, the way the content has been shared and the interaction, the participation, it's not like there were so many people loaded into one batch. There's only a limited number, which basically means that there is that attention that everybody gets from the facilitator. And then there is so much of heavy discussion that happens. It really did not feel out of sync at any point of time, you know? So it was just a matter of getting used to something different, something new. And all it took was maybe 5 minutes, you know, on day one. And I think I have to owe it to the kind of facilitation also that happens with neuroleadership facilitators. You know, you certainly have a knack of making people at ease, you know, because people will come with some, you don't really know what to expect, and you naturally come with some kind of an anxiety. But to make it so smooth is itself, it's really, you know, it kind of alleviates your anxiety to a very large extent. And then you start interacting. It's just a natural conversation that happens. And I think that really helped.
But, you know, Namesh, interestingly, you may already know this, but I think it's important to mention this because viewers will be listening to this.
Mm-hmm.
Our program is actually designed on the AGES principle of learning.
Yes,
the entire program, all of its elements are actually designed on the neuroscience principle of memory recall, which we teach. So, you know, we practice what we teach.
Yes.
Excuse me. Okay, so moving on, you know, the content of the program is the king here, right? I mean, everything else is aside, the richness of the content, you know, and many believe that coaching is all just about questioning, knowing how to ask some good, very powerful questions, which is an important aspect. But you see that in brainwave coaching, you learn so much more about, you know, human behavior, emotions, everything else. So any one or two things that really came up for you during this whole journey? I mean, just two things that you thought were like something that really resonated.
Yeah, sure. I mean, there are so many things. I think, you know, it's great that you kind of touched upon the content part of it, because for any person, when you choose a certain program, the two things that you are looking for, which are most important, one is the content part of it. How is it structured and what is it that really forms the program? And second is the facilitation. How well is it facilitated? So when it came to coaching program, BBCC with neuroleadership, the one thing that I have identified with right from day one is the entire curriculum. The way it is designed, like you said, it's designed with the AGES principle, and it's very true. But the way it is structured, you know, with the breakdown of chapters and how it progresses from point one, and, you know, all the exercises that are there within it, it's a deep dive, and that too without really stressing you out, right? So it's about providing the content, but at the same time making it very practical to understand. So if I'm understanding the content in a very practical sense, I'm getting the research-based understanding, saying this is how it is and these are the reasons why it is like that. So now let's talk about, you know, some practical examples. It also gives me an insight as to why people do and behave the way they do, and how is it that we can help each other in that sense. So I can bring that practicality into my coaching. You know, so when I am having a fact-based approach with my clients, I think they wouldn't appreciate it any less. Yeah. That is what people are looking for. Nobody's looking for any fancy gyan or anything like that. Something that is workable. Something that is factual. And that is what the content of this particular program comes up with. It's lucid and it is inexhaustible. So I keep referring to it and I keep finding something new every time. You know, the concepts, for example, it is scarf. It is so, I mean, when you kind of go through it, you're like, hey, you know what, this was pretty much there in front of me all my life, but I never really looked at it that way. So it just opens up so many avenues. Something like a status. Now I know that if a child is asking for a cell phone at the age of 10 or 12 from his or her parents, why is he doing that? Because it's status. He wants to make sure that he's in the group, the relatedness. It becomes so important. So similarly, you know, it's a very small thing, but these are the trigger points for people. And when you understand these things, or for example, ages, a student learning, typically you have so many examples in India, and when you have to appear for an exam, people so often tend to study through the night and then go for an exam. But here we are learning that spacing is so important, which means your rest is so important. You know, these are small little things, but they matter a lot. And in a coaching conversation, when you work with these things at the background, you're able to drive such deep insights with your clients that it can just be a game changer. So, yeah.
Great. I think, I particularly liked your comment on that you're going back to your, all your book manuals and so much of resources that have come into you through the program.
Yeah.
And I do too. So, there's no never ending, learning in this journey.
Yes.
So happy to hear that. My last question to you is, having learned coaching, and you're a certified, you're certified to coach. Has it made any, one key impact that you think that this has made in your personal or professional?
This is, like I said earlier, it has been one of the most enriching experiences for me. But more than that, what has happened is in the last 7 months, this particular experience has really been a life-changing one for me. In the sense that it has opened up so many avenues for me within myself that I previously did not know existed. So one thing that has come out for me very, very strong is that I've always been very purposeful about having a fulfilling journey in my life, which is to be able to give back, to be able to do something for the society at large. And with coaching, I found that avenue. I found that part which was so important for me to feel fulfilled and complete. So this is that journey now, where I'm able to, I know for a fact that if it's a well-done engagement, which is focused on learning, which is focused on growth, which is focused on the client becoming a better version of themselves, and at the same time, me also going through that same journey, then there can be nothing that can be more fulfilling than that. So in that sense, it has opened up different paradigms for me. And I'm very happy to say that I've started experiencing it already. And every time it just blows my mind. So it's just amazing. It's just helping me become a better version of myself. And that means so much for me. It really means a lot to me.
Great. So exciting to hear that. And on that very positive note, Namish, I want to thank you for spending your little time today in conversation with us. And I'm sure our viewers and these posts will learn from something from that and take the right decisions when they want to become. So thank you very much.